the president and founder of the ABAD program. The reason I started the ABAD program, Austin Boxing Against Drugs, was that I felt that I wanted to do something about the gang problem and the drug problem, because I don't know if you're aware, but up to about 1985, we didn't have a gang problem in Austin. We've always had a darn good boxing program. After about 1985, the guy that was running the program retired, and nobody took it up. So right after that, we started having gang problems, and you know, it just started getting worse. In 1990, I talked to some friends of mine, and I thought about bringing boxing back to Austin, you know, and helping out, because I felt that this is one way of getting rid of the drug problem and the gang problem. It's close to 600 kids that come into my program. Yeah, so I can say 600 kids that didn't get involved in gangs.
Like my coach, Joe Vela, he really works for me whenever, you know, I need help. If I do something wrong, he lets me know what I'm doing wrong so that I can fix it for the future. And it's real cool here. I love it.
What would you be doing if you weren't in ABAD?
Probably be at home watching TV.
I used to work in the rec centers, you know, and even though they have good programs, no doubt about that, they all have fees. There's a lot of kids, you know, that can't afford it. They can't afford, I mean, the fees are not that high, but still the kids can't afford it. And so I told myself, you know, if I had ever had a chance to start a program, my program was going to be free for the kids, you know. Because I wanted the kids to come in here because they wanted to, not because they had to, because they paid.
Just, you know, you get to fight, you get to beat up bags, and I mean, you don't get in trouble for it. It's cool. It's cool.
My name is Ricardo Ramos. Ricardo. And this is Isa Ramirez. And this is Casey. And we said he's got 40 plus fights. He's been state silver gloves runner-up for about 3 years in a row. He's got about 13 fights. He's been off and on, but he just fought the state silver gloves champion of San Antonio, and we beat him.
Boxing again teaches you a lot. And I mean, one, it's self-confidence. You know, it builds your confidence up. You know. And that's very important in school, and not just boxing, but in every sport that you participate in. Teaching you a lot of discipline. Discipline is very important, because you know it's not just discipline in sports or things like that, but discipline in your body and discipline in yourself. You know how far you can go with things. You know, for example, I teach a class from a middle school, and they come down here, and I sit with the kids, you know, and I teach them how to hit the speed bag, and they say, oh, I can't do this, and I tell them, yes you can, don't let your mind, you know, don't let your body control your mind, you let your mind control your body, your mind can tell you what you can do.
Empecé a boxear cuando tenía 13 años, 13, 14, y a los 16 me retiré un poco. Ahora tengo 20 años y estoy empezando otra vez a boxear.
I like boxing because exercise mainly. Feels good to sweat a lot. Win, of course. It's a great physical sport, good contact sport. It's got a lot of tradition inside of it and a lot of history. That's why I like it.
We are real happy because my cousin, he went to win before in different gym, right? But not here in Mexico. It's the first time for him here. And we are real happy because that trainer was pretty good. You know?
Marshall was 17 years old when his mother brought him to me. I mean, he was into a lot of gangs, He was missing school, he was dropping out of school. And he was just going the wrong way. Turned out that he liked boxing. So I worked with him. He went back to school, he graduated. I went to his graduation. After he graduated, he went to the Army. And right now he's all Army champion, 5 times. He's an inner service champion about 4 times. He's a Pell national champion. He's ready to fly for the nation. And he's real disciplined. You know, he's a soldier now in the Army also. But he's what ABAD's all about, because this is what I was teaching our kids, you know, how important it is, you know, to discipline your body, to discipline your mind, you know, how important it is to have an education, you know. And if you have a goal, don't let nothing, don't let nobody interfere with what you're doing. Just stay focused.
I want to be the best.